And welcome into the ballpark. Happy to have you with us. Interleague Baseball on MLB The Show. It's the New York Mets taking on the Cleveland Guardians. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Almost ready to get underway. And on the mound now, Carlos Carrasco. What should we keep an eye on here?
It's always interesting to see how he utilizes all of his pitches and how many of those he has a good feel for on that given day. When he's right, he's really able to keep hitters guessing, and all of his stuff seems to be coming out of the same arm slot, the same tunnel. And that can make life very difficult on his opponents.
Here's Brandon Nimmo. And a foul ball. And there's a ball.
Here's someone, historically speaking, that prefers day games over night games, so I'm excited to see what he does in this one.
Here's a 2-2. Wouldn't chase that time.
I think he wanted that call in the upper part of the zone, but just didn't get it. Now he's just trying to get a better feel for how much it missed so he can adjust his sights just a little bit.
3-2 now. That one ripped. That's back there. And gone. A gigantic blast. And just like that, they're out front. It's 1-0.
Boog, his plan was to hit the ball hard, and he was going to figure out the rest later. You can't argue with those results. Well, you got to love a game that brings some action from the jump. And at the plate, he was looking for a pitch to absolutely drive. And, you know, leadoff hitters aren't up there anymore just working the count, trying to get on. They're looking to make some noise and do some damage.
Up to hit Francisco Lindor, and a pitch. And count 1-2.
Always exciting to see a leadoff home run in an inning. Kind of gets the offense fired up, and you start to expect a big inning.
That misses the zone, and that's ball two.
The real threats are coming up. Already given up a home run in this inning. It's going to really have to bear down.
The 2-2 on the way.
Count is 3-2.
That's foul off to the right side. Keeps the AB going. One run across in the frame so far, and we're just getting started here in the top of the first. Hit hard, base hit.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. Got a fastball, middle of the plate, jumped all over it. Absolutely smoked that ball.
Met it first, and now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso. Carrasco checks over to first, and he's back. And here it comes. And that's off the inside edge. And a count 2-1. Lindor gets his lead at first with nobody out. Pitch inside, just missed.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
Payoff pitch. Now it's belted deep to left, way out of here. Home run. It's their second home run of the inning, and they throw a pair on the board. It's 3-0.
Pitch he wanted to hit, spit on some other pitches in this at bat, was very patient, and it paid off.
JD Martinez stands in, and a pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2.
Can be tough to bounce back after a big home run, but nobody on, nobody out. You just have to treat it as a fresh inning.
The punch out there, and that's the first out. Nice recovery after giving up the homer.
He's really good hitting the baseball the other way. So credit the pitcher for having him out in front of that pitch. Clearly he had him fooled.
And now Brett Beatty. Nope. Just missed.
You know, lots of pitches thrown in this first inning. It's kind of that nightmare scenario for starting pitching. But you know what? It's still early enough. He can settle in. He can get some length if he just cleans up his mechanics a little bit.
Right side, Jimenez. That's it out. Let's take a peek at the Mets lineup here. This is a veteran-led lineup right here. A lot of players with plenty of experience, Singy.
Yeah, no doubt about that, Boog. These players have been around the game for a long time, and they may not have the flash that they once did, but they've got the wisdom to be able to understand different situations, be able to think with the opponent and sometimes in front of the opponent. And you always seem to see a team like this. They come to the ballpark, they know how to get down to business, and they understand what the job is at hand.
On the ground. The throw to first. That ends the frame. But two round trippers in this inning. The long ball was working. It's now 3-0. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Back here with my pal Singy. And on the hill here today, Adrian Hauser. Chris, what should we keep an eye on here with him?
Well, they're going with the opener in this one, so this is an interesting look. He's probably only going to pitch an inning, maybe two at the most, and it's going to be unconventional. I think he's going to pitch backwards, more off speed, and then fastballs late.
And another ball.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
In the air, out towards right center. He's there. He's got it. And there's one down. Here's the Guardians lineup now. Already they find themselves down 3 runs in this game, so there's work to be done.
Yeah, you want to see them come out with a little urgency here. You don't have to score all 3 runs, but put something up on the board. That'll make you feel a little bit better about your opportunities. But if you're looking at that 3-run lead and saying we've got to get it right now, you can put yourself up against a wall and not have really good at bats. So just trust the process. Trust that your pitcher can hold them right there. These players could find themselves back in this ballgame.
And he takes it himself for the out.
Batting third. The third baseman. Jose.
Two outs, base is empty. Next to hit, Jose Ramirez. Two down, nobody on. Foul ball there. Ground ball, left side. Sneaks through, base hit. Now he turns and heads for second. The throw in, and he'll make it to second base with two gone.
Just a simple ground ball the other way that had eyes on it, man. Sometimes that's all you need to do. Just let the ball travel, put the ball in play, and just hope it finds a hole.
And now it's Josh Naylor. Man on second, two down. Line drive, base hit. Coming home. Now a long throw home. It's offline. The run comes in, and it's now a two-run game.
Well done. Narrows the deficit with the RBI there. You see a ball come off the bat like that, you know it was pretty much a perfect swing. And for me, you know, I start wondering, and I'm looking on the computer, what was the exit velocity? This time, 106.
Runner at first with two away. Laureano comes up to hit. Two outs. And that one fouled off.
Well, he got challenged with a good fastball right there. Just couldn't catch up.
The pitch. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Third out, and that ends the frame. But they pick up one run on the RBI single. It's now a 3-1 ball game. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. All set for the start of the inning. Here's the second baseman, Jeff McNeil. The pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout. And now Bader up to the plate.
Harrison Bader.
And a swing and a miss there.
One ball, two strikes.
Bounce to third. Two up, two down in the top of the second.
Batting nine. The catcher, number two, Omar.
Two outs, base is empty. Omar Narvaez up now for the Mets. Two outs, base is empty. And that one is lifted in the air. And that'll do it. Here in Cleveland, we head to the bottom of the second. Stepping up for the Guardians, Bo Naylor. And the right-hander deals. That one fouled off. And a ball and two strikes. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. The wind of the pitch. Fastball right back to the mound. In plenty of time to first, one up, one down.
Good sinker low in the zone right there and produced exactly what he was looking for. Ball on the ground, nice ground out.
And now, Kyle Manzardo. The Guardians trailing by two, bottom half of inning number two. On the ground right side, McNeil sends it to first. Two up, two down.
That's what a good sinker is designed to do. Get a guy to roll over a little bit, hit the ball on the ground, kill some worms while you're at it.
Here's Tyler Freeman to hit.
Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Freeman leads off first with two down to the inning. Up the middle, and that one finds its way through. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away.
Back-to-back singles. Just kept it simple. Blake Buckle with the middle of the infield and took it back where it came from, and there's just no one there to knock it down.
Here's the left fielder, Will Brennan. Two on, two outs. Out towards right center field, and that will fall. Here's the throw to the plate. Tag, save it home. And they trail by one.
Picks himself up an RBI. You know what they say, he couldn't have thrown it out there any better than that, and certainly the case that time. Just flared it back behind the second baseman and dropped it in there.
So first and second with two outs. And up next for Cleveland, Andrés Giménez. Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. Next pitch is downstairs. And the righty deals. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Runner around third on his way to the plate. Throw is fine, and he scores. It's 3-3.
Well, there you go. The RBI machine. Another clutch run scoring at bat.
Yeah, he's been so good in these situations. Call it clutch if you want, but his resume speaks for itself. So two down. Now it's Jose Ramirez. To the right side. McNeil gets it to first. Inning over, and it could have been worse. They get two and draw even again. We head on now to the top of the third. All tied up at three apiece. And we're back. Now, Brandon Nimmo.
The left fielder, number nine.
Well, after scoring runs, this is where you're looking for that shutdown inning. Get that hot team back in there to swing the bats.
And another ball.
Been a rough start on the mound for this guy. His third inning, so important for him to get on track, turn the page, settle in, do all those things you need to do to give your team a little bit of length in this one.
Right through there for a strike.
And catcher on the same page right now.
Francisco Lindor comes up to the plate. Righty delivers.
He's gotten into a really good rhythm. Set down seven in a row. He just wants to get the baseball and deliver it as quickly as possible. Keep the momentum going.
One down, base is empty. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. And the pitch.
The count's full.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Kicks and deals. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Right-hander kicks, deals. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk. That's a great at bat. He saw a lot of pitches and earned a walk. One down. Here's Pete Alonso. Lindor, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Lifted in the air, right field. Brings it in with a nice run and grab. And there's two away. it's J.D. Martinez. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not. He's looking to do damage with every swing he takes.
Two outs.
Two balls.
And a pitch out, but no steal, and it's ball two. Though Chris, through the early stages, he hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deeper into this game. Carrasco will move to first. Lindor back in there. It is interesting, though, when you consider the way the game is run now, doesn't even matter that much if your starter doesn't go that deep because teams are really aggressively building their bullpens. Lindor the move. Pitch misses. And that's a stolen base, not even close.
But with a good arm behind the dish, it's definitely a roll of the dice here to try to steal second base. Man, he can zip it down there so quickly. That was a pretty good throw as well, but really good clean stolen base. He can be pretty proud of himself.
Good job to fight that one off. Tied up here in the early going. Goes down looking. So it's no runs on no hits, no errors, and one left. We head down to the home half of inning number three. All tied up at three apiece. Bottom of the inning. Here's Josh Naylor.
For the Guardians, the first baseman.
A strike, the pitch. And Naylor swings through that one.
This guy's got such a good sinker. As a hitter, you've got to look up in the zone. If you look down, you're going to be chasing stuff in the dirt.
One and two now. Foul ball left side. He'll see another. One, two. Got him swinging. He swung over top of the curveball.
I got to think that was the plan all the way. He set him up with a high fastball and then buried that curveball down low to get him swinging. Now, especially with how effective pitchers work up in the zone these days, that's a devastating combination.
Here's Ramon Laureano. One, two. High fly ball lifted in the air right field. Marte moves under it. Makes the grab. Two down.
Now got it. Catcher.
Whoa.
Bo Naylor at the plate now. Swing and a ball popped up. McNeil drifts towards it. Makes the catch. And that is that. Guardians fail to score. So no change in the score. It's 3-3. Back here in Cleveland. Start of the fourth. And stepping in for New York, Brett Beatty. The pitch. Swing and a miss, and that's strike two. Movement in the bullpen. Pedro Avila up and throwing. Gattis also throwing. Left hand batter waits. Battling here as he fouls it away. Not even close there. Full count, 3-2. at the belt and fires. Line drive. That's a hit. So he gets a hit after a long battle with the pitcher.
Nice at bat right there. Not just the result, but also seeing a lot of pitches. Made him really work out there on the mound. I don't know how he's able to shoot that pitch the other way and still put something on it. That pitch was inside, and he let it get really deep. So pretty incredible hands to fight it off and still get good wood on it.
Go ahead, run on base. Starling Marte up now for the Mets. And a count 1-2.
With two strikes, may see some movement over there at first base, trying to stay out of the double play right here.
Righty to the plate, and that's outside. Next offering misses, and now it's 3-2. Jet McNeil getting on deck circle. On a line, and that's just foul.
But early on that fastball, I'm sure the pitcher taking a note. Look for an off-speed pitch in this next one.
That ball is foul, and the pressure is building. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. And down on strikes he goes. He battled for a long time, but it finishes with a strikeout. You can't be mad at yourself after an at-bat like that one. Here comes the skipper, and we're going to see a pitching change in this spot. Carlos Carrasco is done in this one, and we'll be back with their first arm out of the pen after a quick break. A new arm into the game, the righty, Pedro Avila.
Well, they didn't get much length out of their starter in this one, so they've got a lot of outs to eat up in that bullpen. I think they'll look for some length out of him right here if they can get it.
Jeff McNeil stands in.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
Line drive. That's a base hit out of the left center field. Quick throw back in. Lead runner holds it second with one gone.
Up next for the Mets.
Harrison Bader up now for the Mets. Check swing. Did he go? Yes, he did.
At the dish, looking to lift the ball in the air in this spot. Anything but the inning double play, boy.
And he deals. Good eye in that spot.
Man, oh, man, I don't know how you take that pitch. That's as close as it gets.
Two-two now. Worm burner into the outfield for a knock. Headed for the plate. The throw home. The tag out.
You know, Boone, baseball is a game of split-second decisions, and sometimes you feel the need to go a little bit off script. The message from the third base coach was clear, but the runner had something else in mind entirely.
Omar Narvaez at the plate. Two on, two outs. Next offering misses down and away.
Tough spot right here. A couple runners on. Two ball count. You can't nibble, but you have to execute and finish your pitch. If you leave something out over the plate, it's going to bring in some runs.
Found back our way, and that's out of play. Two outs. Got him working. That's out number three.
Sometimes he wears the emotion on the sleeve, but that's okay as long as he's getting results. And right there, thrilled with the punch out to get out of a jam.
And welcome back to the ballpark. John Chabi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Kyle Manzardo.
Manzardo.
The wind and the pitch. And that one fouled off. The 2-2. Stays alive. The wind of the pitch. Now a fly ball to right center. Sizes this one up. Corrals it. And there's one away.
The center fielder, number two, Tyler.
And now the center fielder, Freeman. Tyler Freeman. One out, base is empty. This one popped up. Alonso has a beat on it. Makes the grab. Two down.
The batter number four. Shortstop.
Here's Brian Rocchio. Two down, nobody on. Oh, and he hit him.
That got him. First base.
I don't care what some players might say. Nobody likes getting hit by a pinch unless you're in a 2 count and there's a knuckleballer out there on the mound.
So the batting order turns over. Will Brennan, the next to hit. Ripped on a line. He's got it. And that ends the inning. Guardians lead one. Still tied 3-3. We go to the top of the fifth. Here's the Mets leadoff man, Brandon Nimmo. Good eye right there.
Well, these Mets, digging into their numbers, have to be happy with the swings they're taking. They've hit 7 line drives already, and even though some of them have been for outs, there's nothing wrong with delivering consistent hard contact. That's almost always going to lead to positive results.
Strike two. Right-handed reliever. On the ground. Jimenez. Tosses the first. One away here in the fifth.
Now
and now it's Frankie Lindor. For Lindor, being drafted out of Montverde Academy, he's a guy that's turned into one of the best all-around players in the game. That's a little bit low. All tied up, and we're at the top of the fifth. Next pitch inside, and now 3 balls and a strike. One down, base is empty. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
He's got to throw any pitch at any count. 3-2. He goes off speed. Gets the out.
So 2 down now. And here is Pete Alonso. And another ball. Kicks and fires. Aye. And now 2-2. Aye. Knocks that one away and will do it again. And a pitch. Got it. And it's a three up, three down inning. And the Mets go down 1-2-3. Score remains tied at three. Back now to start the bottom of the fifth, and taking over on the mound, Joey Lucchesi.
Bringing in the lefty with the left-handed hitter coming up to hit. Classic bullpen move right here, so we'll see how it works out.
Here's Andrés Giménez. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offensive side for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. And the leadoff hitter retired in the fifth.
Now batting, third baseman, Jose Ramirez.
Here's Jose Ramirez. Wouldn't chase that time. And strike two.
Two ball, two strike.
The pitch. Just missing there. And now three and two. Base is empty, one away. Last half of inning number five. Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. The lefty fires. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Foul ball, and it remains a full count. And now the lefty. Well struck left field. And that one hops the wall. Makes the turn and hits for second. In safely. It's a double. And his second hit.
But when you see that many pitches in an at bat, your chances of succeeding go up. And right there, we see the result.
Josh Naylor getting ready to hit. That one is absolutely belted. That's down. One hops off the wall. The run comes in to score from second. It's 4-3. And that's a double.
Nice line drive to the pull side. Bent it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
Second. So in now for Cleveland, Ramon Laureano. And there's a foul ball. Naylor, the runner at second with one away. And that one almost got him. Cleveland up a run looking for more. Off the mark there. Ball three. Activity in the bullpen. Jake Diekman, the left-hander, is getting that big fastball of his ready to go. Lopez, a hard-throwing right-hander, up as well. Hit hard on the ground to short. Fires over to first. And Laureano is retired.
Up next to Cleveland, the catcher.
Stepping up for the Guardians, Bo Naylor.
You have to be careful throwing him breaking pitches, even in an 0-0 count. He loves going after the off-speed stuff, and he's really good at hitting it.
swing. Did he go? Yes, he did.
One ball, two strikes.
Swing and a miss, and he chases that one in the dirt. Narvaez gathers, throws to first, but no chance to recover. He'll reach after the strikeout. So he's able to reach first base despite the strikeout, and that extends the inning. Kind of a tough turn of events for the defense there.
Yeah, it's maybe a little bit of a morale killer. For a second, you think you're about to go hit, but really quickly you have to refocus and be ready for the next play. We'll see if they can work around it.
So two on with two away. Kyle Manzardo digs in for the Guardians. Lefty out of the stretch, runners at first and third. He fouls it off. We'll do it again. And a pitch. That one way inside. Battle here, about to be the eighth pitch of the at bat. Lifted in the air, out to left. Nimmo has it sized up, makes the catch, inning over. But a run will score in the inning on this RBI double. It's now a 4-3 ball game. Back after this on the show. Set for the top of the sixth, and now the Mets DH, JD Martinez. Here comes a pitch. Hot shot to third. Jump throw. Nicely done for the out. Beatty up now for the Mets. There's a swing and a drive. That skips over the fence, so it's an automatic double.
Well, there's something really nice about getting yourself an automatic double like that. You get to stroll into second base without having to worry about a throw or getting your uniform dirty. And now you're just looking for the next guy to kind of do the same thing. Maybe put one in the gap so you can jog home as well.
One out, runner at second. Starling Marte up to hit. With the go-ahead run at the plate, and we're the top half of the sixth. And here comes. Into third now, so runners at the corners and one out.
Well, that was an important at bat in this game, so great job there stepping up to the challenge. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly. Tying runs now just 90 feet away. Just got to be wary of that double play, though. That would strand him and end the inning.
And now here's Jeff McNeil.
I think ultimately you want to tie him up, get the ball in on the plate so that he can't get the barrel to it and hit it to the outfield.
To short, could be two. Steps on the bag for one. Got him. The double play cuts down the potential tying run. So no runs on two hits, no errors, and one left on. 8-9-1 scheduled in the bottom of the sixth. Guardians 4 and the Mets 3. Here in Cleveland, bottom of the sixth inning. And now, Tyler Freeman.
The center fielder, Tyler Freeman.
The wind to kick the pitch. And downstairs, you and I got a chance to broadcast the 2019 All-Star Game, and the city of Cleveland did such a great job. I felt like wherever you turned, there was some type of ad. For the high fly ball near the pole. That one is foul.
Yeah, and I think the players backed it up from the home run derby and the show that was put on between Vladimir Guerrero Jr., Pete Alonso, and others. It was off the charts. And then the game is always special. When you see the best in baseball, you remember how special this game is. And to be here at this ballpark, I think just was the icing on the cake.
Ryan Rocchio digs in for the Guardians. Down, base is empty. And a foul ball, he stays alive.
Well, he hasn't gotten the result yet, but it's got to feel pretty confident. Three foul balls in a row. He's right on this guy.
Gets a piece and stays alive. The 1-2. Swings and misses, struck him out.
The bat.
So the lineup flips over. Now the left fielder, Will Brennan. Two down, nobody on. Here in the bottom of the sixth. Popped up, foul territory behind the plate. Drifts towards it, and a foul ball. Two outs. Got him swinging. Guardians go down 1-2-3, but they hold on to a 4-3 lead. Welcome back. We're in the seventh. We have a new pitcher on the mound, Tim Herron.
These are the spots where relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
Well, one-run game, Harrison Bader up now for the Mets. Looking to get the tying run on base. And another ball.
Well, on paper, it's favorable to have a fairly quick inning here with two of the three hitters he's set to face batting from the left side, same side he throws from.
The line of the pitch. Looked like it was a little bit up. Omar Narvaez up next for the Mets. And the 3-1. And that one fouled off.
As a hitter, you don't know what to expect here in the 3-2. If he'll throw a breaking ball 3-1, he'll do it again 3-2.
Payoff pitch. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again. To third. Oh, can't pick it up cleanly. Safe at first, no play. We'll see how they score this.
Leadoff man aboard on the error, and that puts your pitcher in a little bit of a tough spot right away to start the inning, not where you want to be. So we'll see if he's able to work around it and pick the defense up.
Omar Narvaez up now for the Mets. And a pitch. Squares, pushes at it, misses it. It's a strike. And the count is 1-2.
If you're a base runner, you got to stay dialed in here. Look for anything in the dirt. Try your best to get into scoring position.
The pitch. Wouldn't chase that time. with the tying run on at first here in the top half of inning number 7. Next offering popped in the air, right field. Hauls it in for the out.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
The left fielder, Brandon Nimmo.
Here's the left fielder, Brandon Nimmo.
You know, this is kind of a tough matchup as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. What you tell yourself is, I want to stay square to the plate, try to hit the ball over the shortstop's head.
Bader runs. That's in for a strike. Save at second, and that was not close.
Well, it seems like 90 feet is such a big deal in a tight one-run game like this one. Maybe it's a little bit risky, but they felt good about it, and it paid off. See if they can turn this into a big run.
Bader leads off second with one gone in the inning. Swing and a miss, struck him out, and now two gone.
Well, that's always the key to effective pitching, is getting ahead in the count. And as a pitcher, it really allows you to start expanding the zone. Hitters become defensive, and all of a sudden that plate starts to get really wide. And what happens is,
now on the bump, Scott Barlow.
Pretty big spot he's coming into, trying to strand that runner at second base. So he's going to need to make some quality pitches. He does have first open if he needs to use it.
Here's Francisco Lindor.
As a pitcher, you know the runner on second is ready to push things with his speed. A base hit's probably going to be a big run, so you really have to execute on the mound.
Two outs and one in scoring position. 2-1 pitch is in there, and the count is even. So the tying run at second. Okay. That one missed.
That's a really good take.
Pete Alonso would be next if they can extend the inning.
And he's homered already, so I'm sure he'd love a chance to do some more damage here.
As you can see him trying to shake it off.
And if nothing else, you worry about him getting some dead arm and losing some feeling. But from what I can tell, I think they're going to let him continue. And that's a really good sign.
And here's the first baseman, Pete Alonso.
And things could change quickly here with one swing.
Swing, appeal to first, and yes, he did. He went around. Big spot. Two out. Both the tying and go-ahead runs are aboard. Chase is in the dirt, slider there. And it's in time for the third out, so that'll end the inning. A strong showing there from the Cleveland bullpen. Midway in inning number 7, and it's time to stretch. Guardians 4 and the Mets 3. Back now at Progressive Field. Now the number 2 hitter, Andrés Giménez. Kicks and deals. And another ball. Next offering is in for a strike. And the pitch. And that one missing low. Left-hand hitter waits. Well struck, right field. The one hops off the wall. Should be extra bases. Into second easily with a leadoff double.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. A lot of times in today's game, the fielders are able to get to a ball that stays in like that, but he hit that one pretty well. And if he hits it just a little bit different on the barrel, it's out of here easily. But there's nothing wrong with the extra bases right there.
Now it's going to be swings through that one. It's a strikeout.
Not a big fastball on the mound by today's standards, just low 90s, but when you can pitch backwards like that and sometimes save the fastball for later in the count, it just sort of explodes on hitters and gets right by him. That was the first fastball they've had, and clearly
intentional walk coming here, and that sets up the double play possibility with one away and runners at first and second. And now the right fielder, Ramon Laureano. Two on, one out. This ball's chopped on the ground. Off balance feet, there's one. Not in time at first. It's a fielder's choice.
Well, that's great hustle out of the box to get down the line, knowing that a double play will end the inning. Good job at the finish, reaching out for the bag. Now they got runners on the corners and still an opportunity to pick up some runs.
Bo Naylor digs in for the Guardians. Now a check swing, but he held up. Now snap throw to first. Laureano gets back easily. Jimenez on third. Laureano on at first with two down. Two on, two outs. That's ripped into the outfield. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. Guardians strand a couple, and it remains a 4-3 game. Welcome back, and a new arm on the mound to start the eighth. Nick Sandlin.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect a tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
J.D. Martinez stands in.
A lot of times you're looking for a guy to get that tying run on base, but because of the power, you want him to tie up the game with one swing here.
And there's a ball. Cleveland has some action going in their pen. Emmanuel Clase, the anchor of the staff, is getting ready to close this one out. Henches, the power lefty, up as well. And the right-hander deals. On the ground, out to short. Throw not in time. It's an unlikely infield single.
That's a really tough play no matter who you are, but I think he has a chance to get him at first if he's just able to get that throw off a little quicker. Looked like he took one extra step to set himself and get a grip on the ball.
So a change being made at first base, and here's the pinch runner, Tyrone Taylor. And here is Brett Beatty. Pitch on the ground to third, has some trouble with it. That leaves him without a throw, and they don't get an out on the play.
Well, a big swing of the bat right there. Really important at bat coming up now.
First and second, no outs. Here's Starling Marte. Righty delivers. Grounded to third, could be two. To Jimenez.
Out.
On the nailer. They got two.
The 5-4-3 double plays at gym and baseball, and how can you not appreciate the skill and practice it takes to make this look so easy? Great work by the infield.
outs, the second baseman, Jeff McNeil. Swing and a miss. Slider right there.
Very solid inning on the mound so far here in the eighth. Holding on to this narrow lead. This is exactly what they were looking for.
The tying run is 90 feet away. Out to short. Whips it to first on the run. At number three. Mets lead one. They still trail it here, 4-3. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Jake Diekman. He has a great slider with tons of movement. Now it's the DH, Kyle Manzardo.
The designated hitter, Kyle Manzardo.
Here's a 1-1. Swing and a miss as he was out front that time. At the belt and fires. Cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees. Tyler Freeman digs in for the Guardians. The pitch. That's down and in. Stirring in the bullpen for the Mets. Cole Sulcer getting loose out there. Here's a 2-1. Way
three
high.
Ball, one strike.
And strike two.
We got full count.
Base is empty, one away. Here, the bottom half of the eighth inning. That's a good at bat right there. He was down early in that plate appearance. Works the walk.
The batter number four.
So next, Ryan Rocchio.
Rocchio.
The 1-1 is fouled off. On the ground, could be two. Lindor, that's one. Back to the pitcher covering. It's a double play. Nicely done, and that'll do it. Nothing across here this half. Through eight full, Guardians four, and the Mets three. We're back, and on the mound is the closer, Emmanuel Clase.
Same opportunity for him right here, and he's their guy. Time to lock this one down and get out of here with the W.
The center fielder, number 34, Harrison Bader.
And a breaking ball drops in for a strike. One off the mark. It's 2-2.
It's a good take.
That one misses. 3-2 now. Omar Narvaez waiting for a turn at the plate. Payoff pitch. He walked in. And that will keep things going.
That could be a tone setter for the inning. Four straight pitches and the leadoff batters on base. We'll see if the next guy waits until there's a called strike before he takes the bat off the shoulder.
Clase picks over. Bader back easily. Here's a 1-1. Lays down a bunt to the right side. Tosses to first. Out on the sack bunt.
There was a time where that sack bunt was just ho-hum, very basic, but is increasingly difficult as it's become to get bunts down in the big leagues. Nice job right there.
And next for the Mets, Brandon Nimmo.
Listen, there's absolutely no reason to pitch to this guy right here. You nibble, you see if he'll expand his zone, but don't give him anything to hit. If you walk him, not a big deal. You have a double play opportunity set up.
Hard ground ball, base knock. Here comes Bader around third. The throw's offline, he's safe. It's 4-4.
Couldn't have timed it up any better than that. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch, just shot it through the infield.
One down, runner at first. Francisco Lindor up now for the Mets. And there's the strike. One away, tie game. Go-ahead run stands at first. The shortstop takes the ball. The 2-2 now. And a swing and a miss. Two out.
Typically, that high fastball, if it's close to the top of the strike zone, a hitter, if he's prepared for it, can get to it. But that one just had that little jump at the end, which indicates there's a good spin rate on it, and it didn't decrease in velocity as that hitter's internal clock would expect it to, and that's why you see the swing and miss.
Pete Alonso digs in now. 4-4 in the ninth. They tried to get him to chase on a slider down and away. Tied at four. Got him swinging. It's a strikeout. Slider got him for strike three.
A lot of adrenaline. We can see it right there. And sometimes you just got to let it out. That's an outstanding job of taking that, executing, and getting out of a tough inning.
So bottom of the ninth, here's the Cleveland leadoff hitter, Will Brennan.
No left fielder.
The pitch. And now two balls and a strike. Action in the pen down there. Edwin Diaz, the closer, is getting loose. In there and out 2-2. And a pitch. Fights it off, you'll see another. And he deals. Got him looking. Strike three called on a slider at the knees. Here's the second baseman, Andrés Giménez. And a 2-1 hammered but foul. All tied up here in the last half of inning number nine. That just misses, and it counts for Jose Ramirez on deck for the Guardians. Hardliner. He'll take the jog around the bases.
Hitting a walk-off homer is the kind of thing you dream about growing up. You're in the backyard, you're creating the most pressure-packed scenario, and what do? You come through with the big swing. Well, he was living a childhood moment right there. Nice swing of the bat, nice win for the team.
Close one here today, and your final 5-4. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.
First, for the victorious Cleveland Guardians, five runs, 10 hits.